Only gonna say this once. Booyah!
Nerderotic.com.
I am no fan of cancel culture. I despise Hollywood cancel culture, but I love Hollywood schadenfreude, so I'm a little torn on this one. So I'll report it to you anyway. Joss Whedon exits HBO sci-fi drama The Nevers, and it looks like Joss Whedon was canceled for being Joss Whedon. Whedon was set to co-write and direct the science fiction drama about a gang of Victorian women who find themselves with unusual abilities, relentless enemies, and a mission that might change the world. Sounds like every other drama we have seen over the last 5 years. Now, Hollywood is the land of opportunism, and Ray Fisher from the Justice League, while being a very average actor at best, played this one perfectly, and he got his very first, very bald, very male feminist scalp. The drama is still set to air in summer of 2021. It was handed a straight-to-series order by the premium cable network in summer of 2018. The Nevers was to mark the first TV series for Whedon since he co-created ABC's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and the first solely created by him since the cult 2009 Fox drama Dollhouse. Before that, he created the hit Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Firefly, both of which developed a devoted following that remains strong. Buffy also spawned a successful spinoff series, Angel, which is arguably as good and had one of the best season finales ever. And I love both of those shows. I love Firefly. Just not a fan of Joss Whedon at all. Considering his act, any open male feminist always ends up being a little bit of a creeper behind the scenes. Now, we don't know exactly what happened. I did know somebody who worked on the set at Buffy the Vampire Slayer who said Joss Whedon was a complete tyrant. And you hear that about a lot of directors and producers. Maybe that's why they identify with dictators so much. Maybe that's why they love people like Hugo Chavez. Co-written by Whedon and Buffy alums Jane Ebsen and Doug Petrie, The Nevers stars Laura Donnelly from Outlander and a bunch of other people that I don't really care about because I'm not going to watch this show. And I doubt it's going to last very long without Whedon. And, you know, he is a long way from being what he used to be. And it might have something to do with his ex-wife coming out a few years ago. I did a video on it called Putting Him on Blast. We have parted ways with Joss Whedon. We remain excited about the future of The Nevers and look forward to its premiere in the summer of 2021, an HBO spokeswoman said in a statement Wednesday. I'm guessing he was asked to leave, and Ray Fisher is guessing that as well. Ray Fisher believes Whedon's HBO exit tied to Justice League investigation. Ray Fisher believes that Joss Whedon's exit from HBO The Nevers is related to the investigation into the conduct of the set of the Justice League. Didn't you just say that in the headline? Garbage tier. Ray Fisher alleged that Joss Whedon's departure from upcoming HBO series The Nevers is related to the investigation into the latter's behavior on the set of the Justice League. How different is that from the byline and the headline? Uber garbage tier. I have no intention of allowing Joss Whedon to use the old Hollywood tactic of exiting, stepping down, or walking away to cover for his terrible behavior, Fisher wrote on Twitter. Warner Media's Justice League investigation has been in full swing for over 3 weeks now. This is undoubtedly a result of it. Art over A over E. I don't know. Art over entertainment. I forgot what that was, and I don't care. Listen, I think Ray Fisher's a snitch. I'm not a big fan of his. I know the Snyder Cut fans are behind the guy. And hey, I hope the Snyder Cut is good. And I love Zack Snyder. I'm a big fan of the guy. And I thought Joss Whedon's Justice League was garbage. And if he treated him bad on the set, then yeah, he should probably be punished for it behind the scenes. Act like adults. Don't act like a bunch of children. But that's what Hollywood does. Again, you play stupid games, you win stupid prizes. And if Ray Fisher thinks this is going to help his career, it's not. It might do it in the short run, but in the long run, he's going to be looked at as a problem child, and they're not going to want to mess with the guy. And quite frankly, he's not talented enough to pull shit like this off. But that remains to be seen. So this year of unprecedented challenges has impacted my life, and perspective in ways I could never have imagined. And while developing and producing The Nevers has been a joyful experience, I realized that the level of commitment required moving forward, combined with the physical challenges of making such a huge show during a global pandemic, they're blaming the COOF, is more than I can handle without the work beginning to suffer, Whedon noted. Wow. So yeah, that investigation must be getting pretty intense. Now, we all know that Warner Brothers is affiliated with HBO, and they're all owned by AT&T, who has a lot of scalps right now. They have been cutting a lot of staff, and I wouldn't be surprised if a force majeure happens to a lot of shows, even maybe this one. I am genuinely exhausted, and I am stepping back to marshal my energy towards my own life, which is also at the brink of exciting change. Really? Is that exciting change retirement? I am deeply proud of the work we have done. I am grateful for all of my extraordinary cast and collaborators, and to HBO for the opportunity to shape yet another strange world. The Nevers is a true labor of love that I am no longer involved in, but after 2+ years of labor, love is all I have to offer. It will never fade, he added. Well, I think your career might fade. Cinema Blend broke the news first today. Wow. So this one came out of nowhere. I'm sure a lot of the Snyder Cut fans will be happy. The ones who back Ray Fisher. I know that not all the Snyder Cut fans like what Ray Fisher is doing. I know all the Snyder Cut fans hate what Joss Whedon did. And I think he was probably put in a bad position. Warner Brothers created this mess. Warner Brothers were the ones who screwed over Zack Snyder after his daughter. After the tragedy with his daughter. And we've seen a lot of good come from it. I don't know what Joss Whedon did, what he said, because we haven't seen any evidence, and I doubt we ever will. And let's be honest, it's not even necessary nowadays. And that's why I hate cancel culture. AT&T obviously just wanted this to go away, so much so that they're willing to sink an entire show that they've sunk millions into. Do you think Warner Brothers is going to forget that, Ray Fisher? And they were willing to publicly embarrass Joss Whedon. I'm wondering when Ray Fisher learned the news today, if he went, "Booyah!" Now, do I have any doubt that Joss Whedon is a complete a-hole behind the scenes? Of course not. I also have no doubt that Ray Fisher might be a sensitive stage actor that doesn't like it when people say mean things about him. And he used this opportunity to its full advantage. And well played, sir. You are the clear winner. And I don't think we're going to see Joss Whedon anytime soon. If you like what you heard, please like, share, and subscribe. If you didn't like what you heard, I thank you for listening this long. I'll see you in the next video.
NerdErotic.com. Please subscribe.
Only gonna say this once. Booyah!